Healthcare, as you know, is moving along. Knocked out the CSRs. That was a subsidy to the insurance companies. That was a gift. That was, frankly, what they gave the insurance company. Just take a look at their stocks. Take a look at where their stock was when Obamacare was originally approved and what it is today. You'll see numbers that anybody, if you invested in those stocks, you'd be extremely happy.
All right. Technically, the president right about that, those CSR, those cost-sharing reduction payments made to health insurance companies to provide support or reimburse them for signing up those who can ill afford health care coverage on Obamacare. It gets sort of ripped in the media, but the fact of the matter is their stocks did soar as a result of that backstop being the United States government. We're looking into that and a lot of other bigger issues here with Barron's.com editor Jack Otter. You know, Jack, the government did really lift a lot of these stocks. That's the first time the government has done that for a number of groups, either by staying out or coming in. But it is disproportionate here. So you take that away, then, of course, the next question becomes what comes in its place, right?
Exactly. I mean, I got to say, Rocket Man, all these other tweets, when you really unpack this one, I think it may be the strangest tweet ever from Donald Trump. There's so many layers to it, but start with the CSRs. So, yes, they were a subsidy, right. But what's actually going to happen is more money will leave the U.S. Treasury as a result of this, because all of these people will get tax deductions for higher premiums now. So it's actually
More than the $7 billion.
Exactly.
So if it were accurate.
So it's actually increasing the deficit a little bit. But if you step back and think about why we have this whole system, right? The rest of the developed world all has single-payer systems. The taxpayer gives the government money, the government pays the doctors. We decided in this country that wasn't how we wanted to do it. We wanted something a little more capitalistic. So the way we went was this strange hybrid called Obamacare that actually came out of a Heritage Foundation report in the 70s. The idea was a conservative idea. People should take responsibility for their own health care, and therefore they would mandate health insurance coverage. Well, of course, it got complicated and overly regulated, and there's all sorts of problems with Obamacare.
And the government still had a very prominent role.
Too prominent role,
right.
I would
argue. Right.
But still, you know, it was what it was. And so when you take it away, what's going to happen? Costs will go up also for the government. Hospitals will probably get fewer patients, but the ones who do go without health insurance, the taxpayer will end up, you know, picking up that, or the hospitals will lose money. So there's really nothing to brag about here. Like if Trump were to actually produce a better plan than Obamacare.
But maybe he's forcing the issue. But you rip that revenue away, Jack. All of a sudden, you're compelling people to, oh, my God, we got to scramble and come up with something fast. You're just worried about the cost of the replacement here, right?
Right. Well, under current law, what will happen is that obviously premiums go up because they need to cover the cost, but then those will be subsidized by tax breaks. So we're not actually helping anything.
Separately, out of the blue. Now, he's addressed this before, Jack. He's talking about high drug prices. You and I know that they can be very high here. The same drug, the same treatment.
Sure.
Can be a fraction of the cost abroad. There are a lot of reasons for that, but he was just saying it's outrageous. And that's something that has very popular appeal.
Oh,
so are
sure.
The drug makers the next to feel what the drug, or the insurers, I should say, are feeling right now?
Well, what's interesting, remember when Hillary tweeted something about biotech?
Right.
And the IBB, the index fund, or excuse me, the ETF that covers biotech stocks plummeted, and it took it a long time to recover. The market's not really reacting to the Trump stuff about drug prices. And I guess the market doesn't believe that he's going to do anything. I don't know. But it is interesting that he's not having that effect.
All right. Mitch McConnell meeting with the president later on. There's been a lot of reports of bad blood between the two that extends to Bob Corker. Is he trying to mend fences? The golf game with Rand Paul and Lindsey Graham? What do you make of it?
I would sure think so. I mean, those guys in a room with no reporters and no mic, they have to be able to say to each other, guys, we have a huge opportunity here to have a big win that can take us into 2018 and give people a reason to vote for us. Or with complete Republican control of government, we can continue to do nothing and basically write the Democrats' campaign ads for them.
So if they don't get tax reform done, tax cuts done, it's like, I guess we passed the reforms. What happens?
You know, the only good news for the Republicans is, I don't know what the Democrat replacement is. Do you? Do you know any great candidates coming up? Do you know any great plans? Not really, but they sure will have nothing to show for 2 years in power.
Yeah, you want to show that at least. Jack Otter, Barron's.com editor. Very good seeing you.
Great
appreciate
seeing
it.
You.